Yeah. Yes.
Oh, thank God, thank God, thank God.
Yes,
thank the Lord, church. God's in the house.
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you ain't found him, I don't know what's wrong. God is in the house this morning. Still flowing today. That same blood, that crimson river is flowing and flowing and flowing.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We'll sing one more song. I'm going to have Brother Mike and Sister Brian come up here. They can help me sing this song this morning. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Then we're going to get into the Word of God this morning.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Bless them.
God laid something upon my heart, and I tell you, I just can't wait to see what God's got in store. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I've never I've been this homesick before.
Yeah.
Oh yes, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Glory to God, glory to God. Oh yes, yes, Lord. God be praised for this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Speak to us this morning, God. Speak to us this morning.
Oh, you see me. can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can feel the brush of angel wings. Hallelujah. Sing it, hallelujah. Let God bless you this morning. God wants to do something here this morning. And have to have no preaching. Ah, the Holy Ghost can do more than we can.
Begin to flow. Hey, hallelujah, Jesus. I feel the Holy Ghost.
this altar and pray. It's open. This altar is never closed. It's always open. You have never tied no vacancy upon this altar. This altar is always open.
Thank you.
make a mess.
Oh,
Jesus. Jesus just put his arms around them, just loved them.
Amen.
Just like he done that little child this morning.
That's right.
He put his arms around me. Can I tell you something? The other day there was a picture took of the church. There's an angel that watches this church.
Amen.
And that angel was standing right here by this door in this picture. Sister Bonnie, the other night when the Spirit of God was moving, she saw Jesus. She couldn't see his face. She just seen the
transparent
thing. Jesus was standing behind this, behind Sister Nora.
Amen.
God's in this place.
That's right. Amen.
I don't care what man says.
That's right.
God is in this place.
Amen.
The devil is a liar.
That's right. That's right.
You know, Thursday night I was getting a shower and the Lord spoke to me just as plain as day and said, the devil is a liar and the father of all lies.
Amen.
And I began to make a song while I was taking my shower. And we come here to church Thursday night. Brother Jackie preached an awesome message. Fine job. And the old devil thought he was going to rear his head up. But God intervened.
Amen.
And you say, does God do stuff like that?
Amen.
God intervened right here.
That's right.
With Sister Tanya. Because God knew what was fixing to take place and he shut it down.
That's right.
You say, does God do stuff like that? Yes, he will.
Amen.
I had a message for this morning, but I guess you'll get it tonight. Because we can't outdo God.
Amen. That's right.
Can't outdo God.
Just one more soul to walk down.
Amen. That's right.
It'll be worth every struggle. It'll be worth every mile. A lifetime of labor. Brother Roger, it's worth it all just to see that one soul.
That's right. Amen.
That's our whole purpose here, is to see people saved and get their needs met.
Amen.
You say, God can save little children? Yes, look at little Abby right there.
Yes.
God is really using that girl. I got a little song I'm going to have her to learn to sing. Because I was praying the other day and she came to me. And I said, she can sing.
Yes, she can.
I said, she can sing this song. We're going to work with these young people.
Yes,
I'm telling you, these young y'all want to see some young people that's on fire for God.
Amen.
I'm telling you.
That's right.
Yep. Brother Michael here, he's our porter. Anybody know what a porter is?
No.
The Bible talks of it. They are a guard. They was a guard. They guarded the temple of God. God put the porters in charge to guard the temple, not to let nothing harm the people in the temple, not to let nothing harm the priest that went into the temple to pray.
So he's your bouncer.
The porter. No, he's not a bouncer. He's a porter.
But we know what bouncer means.
It means security. He's security. He's a porter.
So, same thing.
He's our party pot.
But ain't it just awesome how the Holy Ghost can come in?
He is great.
I mean, I see it.
The Lord has done.
Amen.
What the Lord has done. He healed my body.
Amen.
Darkness and shame, I had no hope and no peace of mind.
That's right.
White as snow, and he opened up my blinded eyes. Rejoice, it's a lady of my choice.
I got trouble, peace, and everything.
Yeah. Say, look what the Lord has done for me.
Amen.
He's done more than we can do.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. I was coming down the parkway yesterday and I was praying. In amazing grace, came to me, Brother Austin, and God said, I once was blind, but now you can see.
Amen.
Brother Jeff, we were blind.
That's right.
Brother Roger, we were blind in sin. Sin had us blind. Brother Gavin, sin had you blinded. You could not see. I said, okay, Lord. He said, I once was blind, but now I see. I said, what do I need to see, Lord? He said, just open your eyes. I seen it this morning.
Amen.
I seen what God wanted me to see this morning.
Jesus.
You say, what's God going to do? Eyes has never seen. Ears has never heard. One day after a while, we fixed to see something happen. Brother Wayne, I read your post the other day and I said, yes, it's something fixing to happen. I don't know what it's going to be, but I know something is fixing to happen.
I'm going to get gorilla-fied.
Yeah, y'all.
2018.
Have y'all seen that video that Michael posted on Facebook? There's a gorilla in this swimming pool. And it's like being baptized. And this is what he, the way it does, it's saying that gorilla was getting his shout on.
Show him,
Michael. I don't know how to do it.
But I told Michael I had a dream one night, and I seen him, and we was in this other building. I don't know, but same chairs, but we was in this other building. It was a bigger building. And I seen Michael start shouting just like that gorilla was in that swimming pool. I said, don't tell God you're not going to do something, because guess what? You're going to do it.
Amen.
Amen. When you say,
I want
to do it, that's what you do.
Yeah. And he'll learn one of these days, because every time he says, I won't do it,
he'll learn. He's learning.
Yeah. Somebody said that God would never change his messages, but guess what? God did.
Amen.
And God does, because he changes mine a lot. But I was sitting here yesterday. Sister Connie was playing the piano, singing. It was just like a fog in here. Anyone just sat and watched it, it was just like a mist. I could see that mist in the church this morning. And it's so nice just to come out and just sit in the peaceful of God.
Amen.
Brother Austin, you sitting over there this morning, God was getting all over you. Why didn't you just cut her loose?
He was crying. Them eyes was crying.
I seen God in this place this morning.
Amen.
My eyes was closed, but I seen God going through just through the place.
That's right.
This is old time Pentecostal church services.
It lasts more than 30 minutes.
Some people.
That's right.
Some people wants to go to church. They want to go to church for 35, 40 minutes to an hour, and then they're ready to go home. That's not giving God enough time to even move.
That's right.
God's got to move on his time. You can come in, get up and go through the routine, go back home, and
we come to have.
We came to have church. We come to let God be God.
That's right.
And I tell you, God came in this place today.
Amen.
Did you notice when I was trying to sing that song, my voice started going down? Like my voice was going out. I thought, God, I got to preach. And I heard a voice. I got it.
Amen.
I got it. I thought she was going to take off preaching. I kept looking at her at the mic. I thought, man, she's fixing to wipe. Man, that head, y'all see that head this morning?
Wonderful.
Michael, Michael pulled up a video the other day of these two birds sitting on the back of a couch. They were listening to a worship song, gospel song. They were walking around, their little feathers come up, then all of a sudden that little bird start going. Everywhere we can. Ain't it good to have fun in the house of God? You can have fun in the house of God. The Bible said that laughter is like a medicine.
So respect life a whole bunch.
Amen.
It's been a while back, but I heard somebody on the news was talking to him. They asked him, said, "Why do you laugh all the time?" He said, "Well, the Bible tells us to laugh because it makes you feel better. It makes laughter, makes you, it's like a medicine. It makes you feel." He said, "When you laugh way down deep, and you start laughing and it comes out," he said, "pain goes away." That's why are you a Christian? Well, no, I just know what the Bible says. See, people know what the Bible says, but they just don't do what the Bible says. But as God was moving in the church today, he said, that ain't all of it. Brother Wayne, we're fixing to see more. We're fixing to see more souls saved.
Amen.
We're fixing to get loaded.
We get one, if we get one a service.
She says, because she makes your hair up and stuff.
Everybody says, well, we ain't seeing people saved. We ain't seeing people saved.
Yeah, we are.
Open your eyes.
That's right.
Open your eyes. There's people on live stream probably getting saved that we don't know about.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. I was watching Brother Roger yesterday up here, and they was working. What? I sat back watching. I helped pack the board in one. Roger was in here, and he was taking that drill, and he was screwing them screws in, and his battery went dead. And a thought hit me, just like some Christians, their batteries drained and went dead, and they don't want to get a charge. The only way you can get a charge, what do you have to do, Roger? You have to put that battery back on that charger, don't you? Well, where does Christians get their charge at?
They go back to the altar, or they go back to the altar.
That's what God gave me yesterday when I was watching Roger. That battery said, he said, his daddy also, well, I guess he's going to have to go get another battery. So he goes out there and he comes in with the walt. And I thought, that's just like some Christians. They use them generic praises. They don't really want to get that praise out.
That's right.
Brother Wayne, I don't know why God put that thought in my head, but he come in with that DeWalt, and I said, look at there, that's just like a real Christian right there. They get the real thing.
Amen.
But that little portal cable thing done better than that DeWalt. So don't let the big things look like they're going to outdo, because some things that shines all the time ain't gold. Yeah. Some things that acts like they're Christians ain't Christians.
Amen.
And I believe God was showing me that because of what happened Thursday night.
Amen.
Everything that comes in says, I'm a child of God, and the Holy Ghost sent me here, and the Holy Ghost sent me there. You better make sure it is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
Because everything that comes in is not of God.
Amen.
That's right.
That's why the Bible said, try the spirits and see if they're of me. I gave him the benefit of the doubt.
Treated him good.
I treated him nice. I treated him good. But God seen what was fixing to take place, and God moved in. And I watched it as it came in. Brother Michael. And I appreciate the Lord. I love him. Anybody want to testify? This is y'all's service.
I want to testify. I want to thank the Lord for being here. I'm sorry I'm testifying, Hope. But I have something to praise God for. I have healing. God healed my body.
Amen.
He has helped my legs. I don't have to even have cane. I used to couldn't get up out of the chair. And he's giving my legs working good. And I went and had my scans, and they're all good. And I was blind, and he gave me back my sight. I have got something to praise God for. Right. He woke me up this morning.
Amen.
And that is something right there to praise him.
Amen.
And I'm keeping my battery charged because I might have to do some business with
him. That's right.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
I want to thank the Lord for everything he means to me. You know, I've been dealing with something for many, 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 many years, since I was like 16. And I've been praying and questioning. I know we're not supposed to question God. And I've been doing it a lot. And the Lord's told me, I don't know how many times, he said, I've told you what to do. Why aren't you doing it? And I'm not daddy called. I'm not mama called. The God said, I've been told you to preach my word. Get up there and do it. See, because I knew to fulfill my life for God, I can't wear jewelry because he don't want me to. He don't bother me that other people wears it, but I can't wear it because I feel like God don't want me to wear it. So I want to do what God wants me to do for myself. And that's why you got to do what God wants you to do for yourself.
Amen.
I thank you.
Don't she look like she's lost weight?
Yes, she has.
I don't see how she's been eating the table legs off at the house. But she's lost weight. The doctors told me I lost weight. After they told me that, I've been eating sweets like crazy. Anybody else want to testify? Hey, this is y'all's service. Testify.
Hey, I lost weight when I lost it.
Amen. That's right.
That's a whole bunch of weight.
That's I like that's a good message right there.
But I want to know who Tanya. I told Tanya my nickname Barney Five. I mean, I still got my bullet in my pocket.
Bless him, Lord.
Somebody else.
I just want to thank the Lord for being here. And there's been like a lot of things, you know. God's been showing me different stuff, you know, like bits and pieces of different things that's taking place out here at the church. You know, if everybody would come in and have one thing on their mind.
Amen.
And when you start feeling the Spirit moving, just turn loose and let it go.
Yeah, that's right.
Because years ago, I used to go to Samson Street, and I was so on fire for God, you know, back then. And, you know, I was learning back then. And anytime that I'm going to get prayed for, or if I'm just praying for somebody, you know, feet got to moving a little bit, and I would just turn loose and just start shouting. And I was telling Michael, I said, you know, because he's never been around this, and, you know, it's all new to him. And I told him, I said, if you ever feel, you know, your body going moving a little bit, I said, just turn loose. I said, you watch. Once you get started, or whoever gets started first, that Spirit will go right through this church.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And Wayne put on there the other night, you know, that the Spirit of God's fixing to move in this place. He's given us a taste of what's fixing to happen.
That's right.
But everybody's just got to be, you know,
on one mind and one accord.
Yes, and just obedient. Have, you know, just let go.
Amen.
Ain't gonna just do it here.
That's right. We got a baptizing coming up. And I'm telling you, I want an old tie baptizing. I want to see people when they come up out of that water, man, they just lose it. I remember going to baptizings when I was a kid, about that boy's age right there. And I'd see them dunk them old women under the water, Brother Roger, and they'd come up. They'd have them big old Pentecostal beehives on their head. And they'd take him under that water and they'd come up and they'd swing that head and that hair would come down and it'd be down here. And they would shout in that water and they would shout all the way up on the bank. And them men, they take them men under. They didn't just barely take them. I mean, they immersed them under the water because John the Baptist baptized Jesus. He didn't just say, put him down. He took him under the water and brought him back up. And the Bible said when he came up out of the water, the spirit of a dove lighted upon his shoulder. And a voice out of heaven said, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased.
Amen.
And I want to, when we have our baptizing, I just got a feeling that everything's going to be all right.
Don't let Cece have her phone.
No, no. Anybody else want to testify? Now this is y'all's service. The Holy Ghost has come in. It's y'all's service.
I want to tell you that.
Bless your Lord.
Bless your Lord.
I had a prayer answered today in this church.
Amen. Bless your Jesus.
Most of y'all know that I have twin girls. They're 16. In 2013, they decided to go live with their dad. And they didn't want to live the Christian lifestyle that we choose to live. I promised the Lord that I would not turn my back on him, even for my children. But know that he's got a plan. But I cry and I grieve most every night. I've been praying, and I thought, Jeff, if I could just hear them say, I love you, Wawa, one more time. Because I'm always afraid that I'll die before I ever see them again, before they come around. Because I know they will. It's just if I make it. So today, I usually don't bring the Bible in. I told him to get it out of the van. And I have lots of writing for the past. And I look in the back and I'm looking at the right, and the girls had got my mom in 2013. And Madison wrote, I love you, Mama. And Morgan had wrote, I love you, Mama.
sin is sin. I answered a prayer that I wanted to hear. It might have been then, but I see the words, I love you all. That just put hope back in my heart.
Amen.
Amen.
I didn't even know that they had wrote this. And I know that that's God's way of showing me to hold on. Just hold on. And I'm trusting in the Lord.
Bless
if I never get to see them again, I pray for them to be saved. I pray for them to have a good life.
Bless
you, Jesus. I just thank you, Jesus, for
Amen.
Answering my prayer.
Amen. Hallelujah.
He's always right on time.
He's all time God. Sissy, don't you give up. Don't you give up.
They're coming.
You just hold on. Hallelujah. Somebody else.
Yeah, I want to thank the Lord for His presence here today. I felt Him here today. I want to thank Him for the way He's working in my life.
Amen.
I want to thank Him for delivering me from alcoholism.
Amen.
That was something I thought I'd die being a drunk back when I drank. But God took care of that for me. And smoking, He took care of that for me. I got delivered from it. I just didn't, from all of it. I got delivered from all of it.
Amen.
Never just snap your finger off and done. It's like I never ever drunk nothing in my life and He delivered me from it. Never had another craving for it again. I still don't. And I praise Him for, I thank Him for that.
Amen. So,
I thank Him for my family. I just have so much to thank Him for. He's constantly on the move in my life. And I go back and I think back and before I got saved in 2011, I thought I was happy then, drinking and partying. I thought, well, if I quit all this, why I live? There ain't nothing to live for. But there is some lot more greater to live
Amen.
For.
Amen.
Besides that drinking and all that other.
That's right.
A lot more better. But I just thank Him for what He's done in my life. He delivered me. And He had to stay on me. He just didn't. He had to work on me.
That's right.
He gave me a whooping, I guess you can say, two or three times. But I mind Him now. I fear the Lord.
Amen.
I love Him, but I fear Him at the same time.
That's right.
I know what He can do and what He cannot do for
me. Amen.
I just thank Him today, for I love Him for everything He does.
Amen.
Thank you for this church.
Amen. I tell you. When God does something, He does it.
Amen.
I mean, you could be a full, like Brother Jeff said, a full-blown alcoholic. God will take that whole craving plumb out of you.
Amen.
Every bit of it, just like that. I told you about that black guy up here in Detroit, Michigan. We prayed for him. He was so drunk, he couldn't even stand up. He come into church. But when he got slayed out in the floor, he come up out of that floor, they wasn't a smell of alcohol. He was so strong when he come in that church, you could smell it off. But when he come up out of that floor, Brother Roger, they wasn't even a smell of alcohol on him. There was a big light just like shining around his head. He just had a glow about him. And he'd been backslid on the Lord. He was a prodigal son that I was preaching about. He came back to the Lord that night. And God can do all things. Anybody else?
I thank the Lord for being here. I'm thankful for everything He's done for us, and I'm thankful for the presence of the Holy Ghost this morning.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody else?
I want to thank the Lord for being here today and what He's done in our lives. Something that I've been praying for, you know, and I know that the best is yet to come.
Amen. That's right.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else. Amen. I'm glad that young man came to the Lord today.
Amen.
Amen. You want to say something, boy? You want to thank Him for what He done for you? Go ahead.
He's bashful.
Nah, he ain't bashful. All right.
I'm bashful sometimes.
Amen.
I'm special.
I ain't seen it yet.
Just tell them what Jesus done for you today. That's all you have to say. You don't have to say a big bunch. Just say, I'm glad he saved me. That's all you have to say. He'll hear it.
He's fine.
Look at that smile on his face.
Amen. Even if you don't speak them words, he just...
Yeah, just think it in that mind. God hears that.
Amen.
That's right. I watched his daddy back there just crying, his arms around him.
That's a blessing.
Amen. But doesn't that make you feel good knowing that you're one of your kids?
That's right.
Just came to the Lord. That just makes you want to press on harder.
Amen.
Get the rest of them. Yeah, Lord, you just get on the rest of them. Amen. Amen. Sister, you want to say something for the Lord? I know God done something for you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm not one for many words, but I keep a lot to myself. Yes. Every time I feel like getting stronger to the Lord, the devil just puts another obstacle in my way. So you all just keep me in your prayers. I thank God for what he's doing for me.
Sissy, I believe that word that came forth today was for you.
You got this.
Amen.
Put it in God's hands. Brother Josh, you sitting back there awful quiet. Yeah, I'm going to surprise all of y'all. You see him? The devil thought he was going to stop him. I'm going to embarrass him.
That ain't hard to do.
He said, he told Cassie, he said, your daddy will never ask me to preach out here. And the other day, the Lord spoke to me. Said, ask your son-in-law to preach. So, we was over to his house the other night eating supper. I asked him, I said, I've got a question to ask you. I said, he said, what? I said, I've got something I want you to do. What do you want me to do? Want me to do something about media? Want me to download, fix something or something? I said, no, I got something I want you to do. I said, will you do it? What do you want me to do? I said, February the 8th. I said, you know what day that is? I said, it's a Thursday night. I said, I want you to preach Thursday night. February 8th, he said.
What?
What? Did he just ask me? See, I didn't know he had told them that. But God lays them on my heart. When God lays them on my heart, Brother Wayne, that's who I asked to preach. And I let God do it because a lot of preachers out there just let anything come in and get behind the pulpit. And the Bible said, know them that labor among you. And if you just let... Years ago, before you could go preach a revival, the pastor of that church would pray 2 or 3 weeks ahead of time and say, God, you tell me, you show me who you want to come preach a revival. Well, nowadays, they just call them up and say, hey, come preach for them. And not even know who... Well, I've heard them, I've seen them, but I don't really know them, but I'll go ahead and get them to come. And I always ask people, I say, before you ask me, I say, you pray about it. If God lays it on your heart for me to come, then I'll come. So, God laid him on my heart. And then the devil thought he was going to stop him this week so he wouldn't be able to come. But I told him, this is what I told him, Brother Wayne. I said, we ain't got no big chalkboard up here so you can write 4 or 5 pages full of scriptures and stuff. I said, but I just want you to let go and let the Spirit of God get a hold of you.
I can't wait to see the fire come out of you.
That's what I'm talking about. So everybody that wants to see the Holy Ghost get a hold of him,
pray.
Thursday night, pray every day for him.
Amen.
Because I believe something's fixing to happen. Brother Joe.
Well, I just want to say something what happened I'm going to close my eyes a little bit because it's hard to focus. But last night, went to the hospital because I heard I had a kidney infection or a UTI or something. And the doctor came back and he was like, well, I think you got a blood clot because repeating that blood. And I think you got a blood clot in your bladder. And I was like, oh, great. And he thinks my INR was maybe too low or something or whatever. But God knew what he had in store last night, what was about to be in store. And I told my dad by messenger, I said, the doctor thinks I have a blood clot. And he said, well, I'm on my way. I'm getting dressed now. And when he got there, my dad did, he was crying. He was making me cry. He said, I'm so sorry that I'm not here. Got here fast enough. Because he said, me and the devil went back and forth in the kitchen a few rounds. And he said, I got angry when you told me that the doctor said you had a blood clot. Mm-hmm. And he said, I had to repent. Because me and the devil just went at it in the kitchen. And he said, I got on my knees in the kitchen and prayed to God that God would see. He's saying, you know, I don't want to lose my son. And he said, he came in there and he was crying and stuff. And he told me, I said, it's fine. I said, you know, it's okay. Don't worry. I said, I'm worried too. And they're wanting to do a catheter in me, and I'm not too big on those things. I've been through enough with that. And the guy came in to take my blood. And I was telling him, and he was like, well, we're going to check to see how much fluid you have in your bladder. I was like, how do you do that? Well, do an ultrasound and tell me how many cc's you got. He checked it, it was 12 cc's. He said, you ain't drunk much today, have you? I said, nope, about half a bottle of water. But I said, I went to the bathroom today. I said, I went a lot. And he said, well, I got to tell you, you're going to have to pee in this cup regardless. I said, okay. So I went to the bathroom. I said, Lord, I said, you're going to have to take care of this issue. I said, I'm not used to this. I've been through it, but not this, not like this. And I said, you're going to have to take care of me. And, you know, I'm going to confess something to you. I have not been the Christian that I need to be the past 2 weeks. Well, Josh, what have you done? Have you sinned? No, I have not sinned. It's just that I've let something take over my life on my cell phone, which was video games. And no, I didn't do it in church. I don't do that. I respect the church. But when I go home, I will get on my phone. You can ask Cassie, I'm constantly on my phone playing video games over and over and over. And I told the Lord, I said, in the bathroom, I said, wherever it is, you bring it to my mind and I will take care of the issue. And I will serve you, and I will surrender my life, totally. And I went back in there, and I don't know if you see my pee, but it was dark yellow. I know it's too much information, but I said, I have something, but I don't know what it is. But God knew, and he answered my dad's prayer, he answered his prayer, he answered my prayer, and everybody else was praying for me over through Facebook. And I said, Lord, what is it you want me to do? He brought the field games on my phone. I want you to delete the ones that, you know, delete all of them, but I only deleted like 8 or 10 on my phone. And God's dealing with me. Believe me, God's dealing with me. Because there's 2 games I really like to play. But it will come. I just ask that you pray for me because it will eventually get to the point where I'm going to delete them. It's happened before. I started playing PC games, video games, and my dad prayed for me. He don't need to be playing those games and stuff. And so he prayed for me, and I stopped. I haven't played a PC game probably in 3 or 4 months.
And so, but I can't believe he's the first time I've ever played games.
But God knew what he had in store that night, last night, and he healed me, and he's continued to heal me through my recovery.
Yes, he is.
And I went to the restroom this morning, and like I was talking to Wayne last night, I said, it's one of those things where you know you're going to hurt afterwards, and you just try to not hurt. And I said, and it barely hurt this morning. I said, thank you, Lord, for healing me. I said, thank you for what you're about to do. And, you know, I praise God for what he did last night for me. And I want to continue to, you know, push forward and serve him with all my heart. I don't want idle things to come into my life and me. Because I'm going to tell you something. We have idols in our life that's taking control of our life.
Right.
And when we take the idol things and we're over here doing this, there's one day I played golf class for almost 4 hours. And in those 4 hours, I could have been reading the Word of God. And my dad told me that. He said, in those 4 hours you played that golf class, Dan, you could have been reading the Word of God. I said, I felt guilty. And I haven't put for a long time. But we take these all the things and we get away from God. And he can spend, Austin can spend 4 or 5 hours on games, but you know what? You can take those 4 or 5 hours or a couple hours or whatever and get in the Word.
Amen. Right?
And yeah. Make your life more stronger in the Lord.
Right.
Because we're coming to a day,
bless him, Lord,
that when the Lord, not when he comes back, but before he comes back, it's going to get worse.
Right.
They might be coming in a church house, take our Bibles away. Mm-hmm. They might take our churches away. I don't know what is about to happen. But when he take when they take the Bible away, what are you going to do?
What are you going to read?
What are you going to read? What are you, okay. You're going to have to know the Word by your mind and by studying. And, you know, we need to take the idle things and get them out of our life.
That's right.
And those video games on my phone became my idols because that's all I did. I didn't want, I read my Bible app and I was like, I want to play a real game, to be honest. And that was me putting my video games and my idols before the Lord. Mm-hmm. When the Lord said you need to be in studying the Word of God. And so, what happened last night, God gave me a message in the hospital bed. And I'm not going to tell you what it is, but my dad, he was like, before he went to bed last night, he was like, will you tell me the title of your message? I said, yeah. So I told him the title of the message. And he said, that's a good message. I said, yeah. I said, God gave it to him. I said, I have to preach what God gives me. And I studied last night. I got on the computer. And Cassie came home. And we were talking a little bit. And I started studying and stuff. And God has laid a really good message on my heart, and I hope, you know, that you all will be touched Thursday night.
Bless
but, you know, he's never gave up on us.
Right.
God has never gave up. But the problem is we gave up on him.
That's right.
Amen.
And when we... when we give up on him, we use God as a toy. We put him on a shelf, and we live through our life, and something goes wrong, we take him back off the shelf and say, we need you, Lord.
That's right.
But why should he come to you for, you know, come to you and rescue you when you put him on the shelf for 2, 3, 4 weeks?
That's right.
Think about it.
Right.
It's like having a friend. And, you know, they do a lot of things for you, but when they call and say, hey, can you help me? No, I'm too tired. I'm just sitting on the couch and relaxing and stuff. It's like that. We put things off, but we want people to help us, but we don't want to help them. And so why should God help us, you know, and we're not there to do what he wants us to do? And I just praise God for what he did last night, and I praise God what he's about to do for his church.
Amen.
I read Wayne's post, and I said, yep, it's coming. But we all have to be in one accord.
Yep.
One mind, one accord.
Amen.
And
one place.
We're not there just yet, but it's coming.
Yes, it is.
And it could be 2, 3 weeks, 4 weeks from now. It could be 2 months from now. I hope it's even sooner. But it's wherever God wants for this church and when he wants it to come. And just like I said, I don't know why this is here, but maybe someone here has an idol and you're putting that before God. You need to just take your idol away and put it on a shelf for just a little bit. And get hold of God, because there's nothing wrong with having fun, long as it's Christian fun, long as it's not sinful.
Yep.
There's nothing wrong with playing video games on your phone.
Right.
But when God tells you to get into the Word, you need to do it.
Yep.
That's right.
You need to put God first in everything that you do. Mm-hmm. And when you do that, everything will fall into place. And I will promise you that. There's one last thing I want to say, because the Lord, while I was sitting back there and you were praying for this lady over here, I was looking at Bud, because I won't call you Bud because everybody calls you. But I was looking at Bud, and God was like, go over there. He's raising his hand, touching. I was like, no. I'm going to go there. I have no way to get there. What am I going to do? Pull the chairs out? People are like, what's he doing? And I said, if you make a way, I'll go over and pray for him. And his little boy came up to the altar, and I said, that's a good chance. I can pray for Bud. I can pull him aside and pray for him. Well, Bud gets up and goes right back to the seat. And I'm blocked. I said, Bud, up over. But I'm going to tell you something, Bud. God spoke this in my heart, and I have to tell you. He told me to tell you, you're going through something, and I don't know what it is. He didn't tell me. But he said, joy is coming. He said, keep holding on, Bud. Keep holding on, because joy is coming. And that's what he wanted me to tell you. I don't know what you're going through. It's none of my business, but it's God. It's between you and God. And God told me to tell you that joy is coming. Just keep holding on.
Praise God.
Amen. Somebody else.
One little thing, I want to say I'm thankful for Caleb. Him and Emily are, I see them working together for the Lord. I think that God has a plan for them both. Because it's, I don't know, with Emily, she has drew closer. She has somebody
Amen.
That's supporting her age, somebody that she talks to, and we never let Emily date, so Caleb, you better.
Yeah, but he's
got
those puppy dog kind of stuff.
We took him out Thursday. Well, went Friday to eat, or wasn't it?
Friday.
Well, we laughed the whole time we were sitting there because he just.
That was them jalapeno.
Yeah.
He ate one.
No, actually. He ate one. He told me, he said, yeah, I like hot stuff. I said, well, he wants the jalapenos. Well, they bring him out and he eats one. And next thing I know, his eyes are all watered up. I'm said, are you sure those are the kind of peppers that you like? He's like, yeah. He said, but I don't think he ate it anymore.
I didn't like them the next day.
Why not?
That reminds me, and Nora was at the Mexican restaurant one day and we was eating, and these little girls was in there. And you know that thing on there, if you do it, I'll do it.
Yeah.
You know how the kids, you try this and I'll try that. Well, they took their chips and they was putting the hot sauce on the chips.
Yeah.
And they was eating them chips, and they, that one girl, she said, I can do better than that. So she took her chip, she doused it, she stuck it in her mouth, she was eating it. And that one girl, she said, I'll do better than that. She reached, got a hold of that bottle and had the green stuff in it.
Oh, no.
Needless to say, that chip was green, green. And she stuck that in her mouth. She was grabbing every glass of water or anything she could grab to drink. And the more she drank that water, the hotter it was getting, because it was them habanero stuff. And the hotter it was getting, Roger, she was really drinking. And that little girl said, no, we're going, I got her now. And she said, I can do better than that. And she acted like she put stuff on, put that chip in her mouth. I said, look at her. I said, she faked her out. That girl still, her face was red and water in her eyes, her face was sweating. She was, and the more she drank that water, it was getting hotter. I was wanting to tell her, I said, girl, you need to drink something besides that water. I said, you need to get some cheese or something. I said, because you ain't going to get that hot out of your mouth. And, but that, I thought that was funny how they, how kids will do stuff like that. And they've been seeing it on the internet, is what they've been doing.
Emily's done it.
And,
funny.
How many knows about our confession service last Sunday night? The Bible said confession is good for what?
Soul.
So, Nora looked at Cassie and said, why didn't you and Josh confess y'all's? She said, we was enjoying listening to y'all.
And we hadn't done anything to confess. What happened?
You better repent. Joshua, you need to give me a clean mouth so I can put my piano on.
But,
now I'm going to put my piano up.
Okay.
God's been in the place this morning.
Amen.
God's came in. I believe God's going to be here tonight. I know He's going to be here tonight.
Amen.
Pray over a prayer box.
Pray over a prayer box. That's right. Sister Tanya's going to have to do some work on it.
I'll write some letters.
We had some kids here the other night, and they kind of...
Yeah.
Yeah,
well.
But we're going to pray over the prayer box. Anybody wants to come up and pray over the prayer box? Did y'all like my comment that I put under y'all's picture?
I don't know.
I
haven't been on Facebook much.
Well, I have to tell this one thing about them. I was working at asked Caleb about, you know, this being her first relationship. I said, how, you know, would you take my daughter if another person... And he says, well, I would try. He said, I would take a bullet for her. Well, so that's good enough. So we was at the Mexican restaurant eating, and Shorty, the little Mexican aggravates him. He loves to aggravate Emily, so he was really just getting at Caleb. He kissed her on the cheek. And Caleb reaches over and puts his arm around her and said, she's mine. So that was my answer. Yes, he will.
He liked it better.
And Jeff, he hardly ever gets tickled. He just
grows. Yeah, Ricardo Balthazar.
Anybody else want to put up a prayer box? Wait, lead us off. Bless you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, we pray over these needs. God, this is a prayer box. God, you know each and every need. You know each and every one that's sick. Or God, you know those. God, you know those. God, you know those who need to heal. God, you know those who need to be set free and delivered. God, you know those who need to be saved. God, you know those, God, that needs to be, Lord God, delivered, God, from alcohol or drugs. God, you know those that's lost, God, that's in this body. God, you know the needs, Lord God, you know the financial needs, the spiritual needs. God, we just ask right now, God, that you will move upon you, since you sent your word. And your word healed thee, God, we ask you to move upon it in Jesus' name.
Yes.
God, we pray, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How We don't want to leave nobody else out. If they want to say something for the Lord, we don't leave nobody else out. But I said, look at those little lovebirds sitting in the Mexican restaurant eating a Mexican pie.
Jimmy Charles.
It was funny. I thought it was funny.
Oh, it was funny.
I'm going to ask Brother Daniel to dismiss us today.
Lord, thank you for today. Thank you for bringing us all together. Thank you for your blessings. Ask you to watch over everybody as we go our separate ways. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.